Sea Vloggers, welcome back to my channel Culinary Vlogs by Z. Today we are going to be making curried chicken pies. Sounds interesting? Of course it is. This recipe is ridiculously easy to prepare and is perfect for the fasting month of Ramadan coming up in a few months' time. There are two parts to this recipe. The first is a chicken curry recipe, which you can use only for pies. And the second is obviously how to fill the pies and how to bake the pies. You can also make these and store them in a freezer and bake whenever you need to. So the first thing we're going to do is add in about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And then add in our onions. That's 1 sliced onion. To this, we're also going to add in 1 teaspoon of jeera seeds. And a few cinnamon sticks. So maybe about 3 small cinnamon sticks, and leave this to braise until the onions are slightly brown. So we're going to wait for this to turn to a light brown. You can see it's already getting browned. And then add in your chicken. To this chicken, we're going to add in 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 2 teaspoons of ginger garlic. So leave this to cook until all the water is evaporated. So after about 15 minutes, I'm just going to add in 2 diced potatoes. So make sure they're cut in small pieces. Then I'm going to add in 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, and 1 teaspoon of cumin powder. To this, I'm also going to add in about 2 tablespoons of tomato puree. So I'm using a teaspoon, so I'm just going to make it 4 teaspoons. And leave this to cook on medium heat. So we're going to wait for the water to dry up completely. So then we're just going to add in about 1 cup of frozen peas and leave this to simmer. So you must remember that you have to have all the water out of this curry, otherwise you cannot use it in your pie dough. Okay, so once this has cooked, we're going to leave this to cool. And then smash it up a bit so that the potatoes and the chicken are not too big pieces. Okay, so now that it has cooled, we're just going to smash it up a bit so that we don't get too big pieces of potatoes and chicken in our pies. So now we're going to start with our pies, and for that we're going to need the filling, of course, some flour to dust onto the surface, one egg beaten, then we're going to need some foil cups like these, and here I've got 1 kilo of butter pastry. So start by dusting the surface with some flour. And then we're going to open out our pastry. Like so. So I'm just going to fold the dough like so. And then just press it down. Then using a rolling pin, just flatten this out. So roll this out until you have a nice rectangular shape. Now, depending on the size of the pie cup that you have, we're going to place this on top of the pastry, like so. And just cut around it so that we get the exact size required for the pastry. Okay, that's one of them done. Let's do another. So you should get about 18 circles like these, meaning we're going to have 9 pies, and we're going to use one piece for the base and one piece to cover. So let's fill these pies. So now we're just going to take an oven tray like this and get our foils ready to make and fill the pies. Okay, so start by placing one of these over and just push them over like so, so that you have a lovely meat pie. Don't forget to press down at the bottom. Okay, that's our base done. Now we're going to take 2 tablespoons of filling and place it in the center. That's 1, and that's 2. And then we're going to slightly egg wash the edges. Make sure that it has a proper place to seal, otherwise you're going to have gaps in your pies. Then we're going to take another sheet and then join it to those edges. And that's one pie, nicely done. Perfect. So you can also take a dessert fork like this and make a lovely pattern on the edges. And then we're going to put a little egg wash on the top. And also sprinkle some sesame seeds over this. Now, doesn't that look amazing? So from this recipe, we got about 9 pies, and we're just going to place this into a preheated oven, 180 degrees Celsius, for about 45 minutes. And here you have it. Your pies are all ready to be eaten. They have the perfect layers in between, your filling inside. I'm just going to wait for this to cool and then I'm going to serve them. Now, wasn't that easy? Enjoy making these at home and let me know in the comment section down below if you've tried the recipe. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.